Teresa Rigby, 3.5-year veteran of the Baltimore City Police Department, was dispatched and on Interstate 83 in the northbound lanes for a single car accident. As a local landmark, this is near the Pepsi bottling plant. And while she was attending to that single car accident in preparation for the vehicle to be removed from the scene, a second car traveling northbound lost control and struck the rear of the officer's vehicle. Still undetermined whether the police vehicle struck the officer or in her effort to avoid being struck, Officer Rigby went over the retaining wall and fell approximately 20 feet to the pavement below. People at the scene called 911 to get summons aid for Officer Rigby. Responding officers and medical personnel from the Northern District located her on the ground below and began immediate medical attention, and she was transported to the hospital here. Dr. Scalea will update you on her condition. Her family and her friends and relatives are here, and we've had great opportunity to brief them. We're obviously concerned about her condition, but we're extremely optimistic. She's getting the best care in the world, and a lot of people are here to support her and pray for her. I want to introduce the mayor, who's had an opportunity to talk to the family and to see the officer.
At approximately 10:15, Officer Rigby was admitted to the Shock Trauma Center. She was arousable but not awake. She is currently on full life support. She has a number of very serious injuries. She is in critical condition. She is somewhat tenuous yet, though we are making some progress. And we hope to be able to start addressing the injuries that need surgery, perhaps as early as later today, but we're going to be in this for a while.
Thank you very much, Dr. Scalea, and the whole Shock Trauma team for the care that they've given to Officer Rigby. We're keeping her and her family in prayer. Her mother is remarkably calm, but also very grateful because she knows how much worse this could have been. I mean, there are definitely serious injuries, but she understands, and I think we all understand how much worse it could be. So we are grateful and we're praying for a speedy recovery and that she's able to have the injuries addressed as quickly as possible. So again, thanks to the team for being here.
Guys, we'll take a couple of questions. Dr. Slay has got to get back upstairs, so let's make it brief.
At what point will she have surgery? I mean, is this something, a question in hours? Are you waiting for her to stabilize?
We are still in a very dynamic phase of her care. We are still stabilizing her and identifying the remainder of her injuries. As you know, we like to get these things repaired as quickly as is medically prudent. I'm just not sure what that means just yet.
From her injuries, does it appear that she was struck by the car, by her patrol car that was struck, or does it appear that it's hard to tell?
It's always very hard to tell. She sustained a significant blunt force injury, very consistent with the story such has been articulated. I have no reason to think that it happened anyway other than has been explained to you.
Hate to be too gruesome. Legs broken?
Yeah, I prefer not to get into the details of her injuries other than to say that it's a lot more than one and they're pretty serious.
They said originally that she was conscious and alert. Did she have to go on full life support for specific reason?
She was not conscious and alert when she got here.